Philippians 4:10 through 13. I rejoiced greatly in the Lord that at last you renewed your concern for me. Indeed, you were concerned, but you had no opportunity to show it. I am not saying this because I am in need, for I have learned to be content whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do all this through him who gives me strength. In this passage, we see the Apostle Paul speaking to the Philippian church. Earlier in this letter, Paul expresses the value in knowing Christ, the joy of imitating Christ, and then we come to this part where Paul reminds us to be content in Christ. Paul doesn't talk about the things he has, and he doesn't talk about the things he doesn't have. Instead, he tells us that in every circumstance, he has learned to be content. There are going to be times in your life where you have more than you need, and there may be times when you don't have the things you do need. Regardless of your situation, you should find contentment in Christ. You might be tempted to compare what you have to others. When you find yourself comparing something you have to what someone else has, you are no longer content with the blessing God has given to you. In fact, you are essentially saying, God, why didn't you give me this? I need it. In essence, what you're saying is, God, I think you got it wrong. I need these things. So how do you fight off the temptation to not compare yourself to others? Ask God to give you the strength to overcome the desire to compare yourself to others. Verse 13 is a popular verse. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. You might see people using this as a slogan in the sports world, like from an athlete looking for the strength he needs during a big moment. Or maybe you have heard it from somebody who is about to face a difficult task, like a math test. However, this verse is talking about contentment. Being satisfied with the things you have or don't have. Christ is enough, and you don't need anything else. Are you living with this attitude? Is Jesus enough, or do you tell yourself, if I had this, I would be happy? The cold, hard truth is that because of our sinful nature, we will never have enough when we compare ourselves to others. Be content that you have Jesus. If you don't have a relationship with God, then comparison might be a big struggle in your life. Jesus wants you to know that he can fill the void of what is missing from your life. You don't have to live your life always trying to measure up to people. God loves you and he thinks you're really great. Ask him to help you find peace, joy, and contentment in knowing and trusting in him.
What do we do if we are struggling with contentment?
Why do we struggle with contentment?
Dear God, I just come to you today and I thank you for all the blessings that you've given us. I just pray that we would take this lesson to heart and that we wouldn't compare ourselves with others and that we would be content with what you have given us. And I pray that we would all realize that we are unique and precious in your sight and that you made us this way for a reason. Thank you for all that you do for us. In Jesus' name, amen.